Hey, and thank you so much for joining me in today's Take 5 Arts video for the month of March. While I am struggling to find the exact right page that I want to use for this spread, let me tell you just a little bit about what Take 5 Art is, and then I will tell you the prompts. So Take 5 Art is a challenge that me and a group of other ladies do every single month. One of us picks 5 prompts and we create art with it. This can be anything from an art journal page like I usually do, or a regular artwork, a card, anything you like. As for the prompts, this month they were chosen by Amira in Oz Art. Her handle will be on the screen. And the prompts are: 1. Theme. Portray your inner emotions in your piece. Prompt number 2 is a figure from a magazine. When I started this, I was really happy. I felt joy, so I decided I wanted to use this image and the joy ink. But I could have called this video "Watch Me Have a Mood Swing," because it ends up being a totally different piece than I anticipated. Number 3 is use a mixed media background, which I had different plans in the beginning, but I wanted to use gesso, use the ink, some acrylic paint, and maybe crayons. Number 4 is cut out or collage words, which I am starting with. And number 5, the one that I almost forgot, is just a doodle. If you would like to join us, we always love to see this. Just tag us or use the hashtag Take5Art or send us a message. We all love to see it. We share it with each other if you send one of us a message, so don't hesitate. Diving right in, I wanted to use a lot of positive phrases reflecting the joy I was feeling as well. And so I got those out of magazine, old vintage books, any words that I had laying around, as one does. But yeah, I decided to focus on positive phrases because I was feeling very positive. But these are things that are about things that both give me joy or are joyful words. And what I'm doing is I am collaging. I am using the words to create a background collage. And my initial plan was to leave it a little bit see-through in the end. I covered more than I had planned. And my goal was to create a very layered look so that even when I do a little bit of gesso, white gesso over on top of it, it would still have a great texture, which also adds to the mixed media. It's paper and gesso, but I later on add paint, so that's two of the prompts covered. So unfortunately something went wrong while recording. I'm not sure what happened, but my footage was corrupted. A lot of what I did wasn't shown, so I will just tell you what I did quickly before you see how that looks. I basically mixed white gesso and clear gesso to create a little bit of a translucent layer, and then I added some of the yellow acrylic paint using the stencil that you see on the screen, and I used the ink, the joy ink, to create splotches. And this is where we are now. I decided that I absolutely did not like the yellow and the brown together with the background. I don't know why, I just didn't like it. So I decided to cover it with a thin layer of white gesso, just white gesso, not mixed with clear gesso. And while doing this, I remembered that this ink is pesky. It does not want to be covered by anything, especially not gesso. It just keeps shining through, but I don't know, brown is my aesthetic. But it shines through a little bit, and I decide in the end that I will just go with that. Go with the flow, go with what your page is doing. And I am very happy with my past self that I decided that I really wanted to create this layered look with the words. So even though they are covered up and you don't see what they mean anymore, you still see a little bit of the texture that I created. And that is my mixed media background for you. It is a mess. Unfortunately, I also spilled some of the brown ink onto the face of Audrey Hepburn, the image that I wanted to use. I tried to rub it off, but it didn't come off. The ink didn't come off, but her face came off. So it left only a little ink stain, so I decided to throw that away and start looking for a new image. And I remembered that I had found an image that I absolutely loved in the newest Flow magazine. This image has a totally different mood. She looks a little bit sad, a little bit tired, which was exactly what I was feeling at that moment. So it turned out perfect. So I got her out, found a position that I liked, and glued her down. I also got paint on my sweater, so somewhere here I changed sweaters. For those of you who noticed those details. So the ink really didn't want to be covered up, so I decided to go with the brown look and used one of my water-soluble crayons to create more splotches, more prominent splotches, in order to add to the mixed media aspect of the background. And because I changed my image completely, my old plan had gone out of the window. And I decided to just go through my sticker stash. I found these beautiful washi plant stickers and decided to just go with my, if you don't know what to do, just add stickers motto. And I absolutely love the effect that washi stickers have. So I'm glad I changed my plan. I think this spread turned out to be beautiful. It's a perfect reflection of how I was feeling. Tired, unsatisfied, and a little bit burnt out. When I was done with the stickers, I thought, how can I add some more interest? Because the page was feeling a little bit too empty for my taste. So I decided to use some letter stickers to create a quote. And I say create because I just made up this quote as I went. As I said, I was feeling a little bit burnt out, so I decided to tell myself that I need to slow down a little bit. Remind myself of that in this quote. And I discovered that I didn't have enough stickers in of one color in the middle of doing that. So I just decided to go with the flow and take other colors too. And this quote also didn't fulfill my need of maximalism in my spreads, so I decided to add even more text and some hearts. And then I almost forgot the last prompt to have just a doodle in there, and it was perfect. I felt like it could use some more hearts, some more self-love. So I used one of my crayons to doodle, as I had intended to. I just doodled some hearts. And that is it for this spread. Thank you, Amira, for the great prompts. And if you would like to see more of my videos, please consider subscribing, liking, commenting. I love interacting with you guys, so thank you again for watching, and I hope I will see you next time. Bye-bye!